A fitting tribute to Sheffield United's Maddy Cusack in what has been a very difficult week, not just for women's football, but football in general. Most importantly, though, all of our thoughts are with Mammy's family and friends. Familiar faces, but the start of what feels like a bright new era for the Lionesses. Euros winners in 2022, World Cup final defeat just over a month ago. Now Serena Wiegmann's team go again. And for the first time ever in the new Nations League with the old enemy of Scotland, the visitors to the northeast of England tonight. The latest edition of the world's oldest football rivalry. And it is live and in full on Talksport. Both sets of players take the knee ahead of kickoff, and England's Georgia Stanway will get the game underway. England playing from left to right in the first half in white shirts, blue shorts and white socks. Scotland, the visitors, dark blue shirts, white shorts and red socks, playing from right to left. England look for Lauren Hemp immediately up the inside left channel. The current defender is McLaughlin, and Hemp has kept the ball in play. Down by the dead ball line. Early cross to the far post, steered away by Doherty. Well, that was a nervy start for Scotland defensively. Inside the opening seconds of the game, England looking to profit very early on. They have the ball on the halfway line with Alex Greenwood. And now Millie Bright, who's right at the lip of the centre circle. England starting brightly very early on as we watch from our lofty perch just to the right of the halfway line. As we look at it, a steep drop down to the foot of the west stand below. I can already see the Scotland manager, the Spaniard Pedro Martinez Losa, pacing up and down in his technical area, and Serena Wiegmann remains sitting in her spot in the dugout. Lots of live football across the Talksport network this weekend, including Burnley against Manchester United in the Premier League, live and exclusive on Talksport tomorrow at 8. We've got boxing for you as well, as the Lionesses come forward down the near side, the right with Hemp, and they're already causing Scotland plenty of trouble with just over a minute of play gone. England have it with Hemp back towards the middle of the Scotland half, and Jess Carter, who plays it square to Millie Bright. Scotland defending very deep. England nil, Scotland nil, and here's Lucy Ward.
Yeah, first thoughts, Joe. England are playing three at the back. Chloe Kelly left wing back, Lucy Bronze right wing back, and they're playing very expansive. Both wing backs hugging the touchline, trying to make the pitch as big as possible. Scotland defending quite narrow, as we'd expect. Had a little bit of a wobble the opening sort of 10 or 15 seconds. I think England have had most of the possession, but that's what you probably expect at the start of this game.
Well, this is the start of the Nations League for England, and an opportunity, if they reach the finals in February, to potentially progress to the Olympics in Paris next summer as Team GB. And most importantly, though, as Serena Wiegmann has said, I think, it feels like a proper competitive way to do football in between major tournaments. Lucy Bronze crosses right-footed, skims off the head of Rachel Daly. It'll fall to Chloe Kelly at the back post. England nil, Scotland nil. Katie Zellum on the edge of the penalty area for England. Scotland haven't got out of their own half in the game so far. Deep ball cross-field by Carter towards Kelly far post. McLaughlin heads it out of play. England throw deep inside Scotland territory. All England in the opening couple of minutes.
Yeah, Rachel Daly up front with Lauren Hemp, and there's basically that two tens behind them in Georgia Stanway and Lauren James, with Katie Zellum just backing them up, and the centre-backs are right up the pitch halfway into Scotland's half as well, just so that Scotland can't get out, and just trying to control the game. England trying to find spaces that they can pass into in the final third, but they've certainly got control in the opening minutes.
Sold out the Stadium of Light this evening as Lucy Bronze crosses deflected from the right. It's chested down by Rachel Daly, down by the corner of the penalty area. England, who so nearly went all the way at the World Cup just over a month ago, beaten in the final by Spain. Daly's cross for England, deep to the far post. It might still reach Chloe Kelly here. Kelly faced up by Emsley, plays the ball back to Greenwood for England. Greenwood's deep cross, and Doherty, well, she must have got the call from the goalkeeper to flick that behind. She did, and it's an England corner away to our right in front of the Roker end of the Stadium of Light, where there are lots of Scotland fans gathered.
Yeah, Scotland are playing really, really deep, and it's encouraging England onto them. They're doing it so that England don't beat them for pace in behind, but it just means that they're absorbing a lot of pressure. Be interested to see whether that's just a tactic for the opening 10 minutes or so, whether it's throughout the game.
3 minutes gone, and 0-0 it remains on Talksport. Live and in full. Katie Zellum will take the England corner. First of all, though, the referee has an infringement to keep an eye on inside the penalty area. The Italian referee tonight, Maria Sole Caputi. And Zellum with a right-footed delivery, driven high towards the edge of the six-yard box. Up go the heads. Millie Bright beaten in the air this time by Martha Thomas of Scotland, the centre-forward who was just joined Tottenham Hotspur from Manchester United, did so on transfer deadline day. But England have been camped inside the Scotland half for the whole of the first 4 minutes of the game. 0-0 it remains, but if this pattern of play continues, it feels only like a match of time before England open the scoring. And that against a Scotland side, who may be ranked 23 in the world, but have been excellent in the last 6 months. And many of the Scotland squad, including Caroline Weir, who England fans may know from her time at Manchester City and Arsenal and Liverpool, have spoken about real progress, Lucy, that Scotland have made over the last four, five, six games in particular.
Yeah, I mean, having watched a bit of Scotland, read about them, done a lot of research, I'm really surprised that this is how they've set up and they've not really got hold of the ball, tried to get hold of the ball. Yes, the shape, they're sort of sitting inside England's shape, so all the space is out wide, England enjoying themselves, but having said that, not really threatened Scotland's goal.
Game Day Live returns for you on TalkSport tomorrow from 1 o'clock with Adrian Durham, Ray Parler, Trevor Sinclair and Adrian Clark. Goals as they go in from the Premier League, the EFL and a full classified results service. At 3, Luton Town against Wolverhampton Wanderers, a game that Faye Carruthers is going to be keeping a very detailed eye on. That's on TalkSport 2. And at 8 o'clock, Burnley against Manchester United in the Premier League. That's all followed by Fight Night Live, the rematch between Zhilei Zhang and Joe Joyce live from Wembley Arena. All the reaction to the weekend sport, the weekend's football on TalkSport Breakfast every weekday morning from 6 o'clock. And a bonus for you on Thursday and Friday morning on TalkSport Breakfast. Yes, Adam Brazil and Ali McCoist are going to be live in Rome ahead of the Ryder Cup. What could go wrong? Here is Lauren Hemp down the England right. Plays it back to Georgia Stanway. First time crossing to the penalty area. Well, it wasn't dealt with convincingly by Sophie Howard, the Scotland centre-half. In the end, the captain Corsi had to come across to win a throw-off, a goal kick-off, Lauren James. Scotland, again, cannot get out of their own penalty area at times. England 0, Scotland 0. 6 minutes gone on TalkSport.
Yeah, England completely dominating possession. I think Scotland are very aware of the fact that they haven't really got the pace in centre-back areas. They've got two good defenders, Corsi and Howard. But in terms of any sort of foot race, you know, they're going to lose that. So they're aware of that. They're as compact as they possibly can. And what they're just going to do is, looks like, they're just going to stop the space for England to pass into, give them the space out wide to cross and then deal with the ball into the box. And to be fair, that's exactly what they've done.
Belgium 0, Netherlands 0 in the other game in England's Nations League group. That got underway at 7:30, about 15 minutes before we did. Early cross to the near post by Stanway is deflected behind by Sam Kerr. No, not that Sam Kerr. Scotland Sam Kerr, wearing number 8 in the dark blue shirt of Scotland. And England have another corner away to our right in front of the Roker end. And you can hear the tens of thousands of England supporters, many of whom are still taking their seats in the stadium, as Katie Zellum puts two arms up into the air and England get ready to take their second corner of the night so far. Still 0-0. Plenty of white shirts in the penalty area. Hoisted in by Zellum towards Stanway. And the downward header from inside the six-yard box is wide. Should she have done better, Lucy Wall?
Yeah, I mean, we're talking about Katie Zellum in this team. And one of the main reasons, obviously her passing, but also a set-piece delivery from that side. And she can just strike through a ball. It's very difficult. It's sort of like an outswinger, but it's more or less straight right foot from the right-hand side. And probably should have done better with the header because it's actually put on a plate.
There's torrential rain in the build-up to this game in patches in the northeast, but it's abated now. A slick playing surface as England, with Chloe Kelly wearing number 7, playing in a left wing-back role tonight, looking to thread it through the middle towards Rachel Daly. And there's so much versatility in the side, Lucy, as the ball goes through to the Scotland goalkeeper, Lee Gibson. So much versatility and ability to be flexible in this England group.
Yeah, the girls are intelligent now. The tactical nous has increased. I think Serena Wiegmann and their club coaches helped that. But Wiegmann is top level in terms of her tactics and plus her assistant as well. So these girls know when they can move into different shapes, when they need to hold and keep possession, and then when they get themselves forward quickly. It'd be difficult against Scotland if they're going to sit back. At the moment, Scotland have the ball, but as soon as they sort of pass it forward, they might lose it. But if they can tempt Scotland out, that's where England will be the most threatening.
Well, you've got so much live football. If you like your live football, you will love TalkSport and TalkSport 2. Best way to be across everything is to download the TalkSport app. That way you can swipe between both stations and all manner of live sport at your leisure. Tonight, a massive game in the Super League on TalkSport 2. Salford Red Devils against the Catalan Dragons, the final round of the regular season Both sides need a win. We'll keep you up to date with the game of the Championship, Birmingham against QPR. NFL tonight on TalkSport 2, the New York Giants at the San Francisco 49ers. And once we're done here tonight at the Stadium of Light, you can have your say on the Sports Bar Weekender, 03717. Double two, double three, double four. Scotland coming forward for the first time in the game. It's Kirsty Hansen, the number 10, down the England right, the Scotland left, and Lucy Bronze just came across with great authoritatively, and a nice little shoulder barge and out of play off the boot of Hansen for a goal kick to England, 0-0.
So Earps plays short from goal kicks to a centre-backs who have stood in the box, and it, actually Scotland has set up quite well to press, and it's, if England can get past that, then there's a lot of space on this pitch. A couple of short passes, then a longer one from Greenwood. But that's where Scotland can win it.
And Howard has made a mistake, and England are on the attack. It's three against three. James driving through the middle. Threaded ball, great weight on that towards Daly! And the tame shot, rather tame shot, is gathered down low to our left by the goalkeeper in bright yellow, Lee Gibson. What a wonderful way to pass that was, though, from England's Lauren James. And that has the England fans finding full voice.
Yeah, I think this is where Lauren James will find some joy in this game. So basically England had a goal kick, they pass it, and they pass it to players under pressure. Scotland go and press, and then there's a longer ball, and that longer ball managed to get James past the press, and then it's just Scotland retreating, and what a ball it is through to Rachel Daly, and she got to it first, but she couldn't really get the power of the left footed shot.
That's the voice of the former lead striker Lucy Ward alongside me in the commentary box right at the back of the main stand, a very lofty perch. I'm glad you've got the binoculars tonight, Lucy. Here is Millie Bright for England.
It's a good job we know these players. Actually, yes. Even I can see from here how wonderful that Scotland shirt is, by the way. I mean, they win the battle of the kits tonight.
It's a beauty, isn't it?
Unbelievable kit.
It's a classic. England against Scotland. A rivalry that you never want to miss. Live on TalkSport. Opportunity for Scotland on the far side there, right? It's Christy Grimshaw, who plays her club football at AC Milan. Dead ball line crosses, steered away by Millie Bright. Loose ball drops to McLaughlin on the edge of the area. Now, McLaughlin wasn't whether... I don't think she was sure whether to shoot or pass. In the end, got caught in two minds and did neither. And it's gone out of play harmlessly for a goal kick to England. 11 minutes played. And it's goalless in the Nations League on TalkSport.
So, to be fair to Scotland, they've been really, really patient. And they've actually looked the most threatening. I know that sounds weird because Scotland are sitting back on the edge of the box or just into the box, not giving England any space. England are pushing players forward, and because of the way they're playing England, they leave gaps on the counter, and Scotland have looked a little bit more dangerous when they have won it back, and just decision making in the edge of the box there probably could have resulted in a chance on goal.
Well, Scotland are on a run of four wins in a row and six without defeat if you want to go all the way back to February. And their head coach, Pedro Martinez Losa, who has really brought the side on in the couple of years that he's been in charge. He used to work as the Arsenal boss at one time, a couple of domestic cup trophies in the cabinet at Arsenal when he was there. But his team are suddenly on the back foot again because England have it with Chloe Kelly. Far side, the England left. In front of that, two-tiered east stand. Back she goes to Alex Greenwood, who's midway inside Scotland territory. Greenwood floats the ball forward to the dead ball line. Lauren James, the first time cross up towards Hemp. That's a good header away at the heart of defence by Howard of Scotland. England have it back now, the Lionesses, with Carter, and now Bright in the centre circle. I guess it's not a great surprise to see England go with the back three, because that was what they used for most of the World Cup. And a miscue by Howard. She gets lucky. The ball swung off the foot of the defender after the cross from Kelly, but it's gathered by the goalkeeper, Gibson.
Yeah, I mean, quite a lot of people think that three at the back is a defensive shape, but it can. There's a lot of bodies beyond the ball that you can still have two up front and an extra one in midfield. So actually, it's quite a positive shape, and that's how England use it. You know, they're very sound defensively, but they don't play defensive. And I think that Lauren James is a key player here. Sam Kerr will have to keep an eye on her because she just keeps drifting into space. But again, the problem with England is they have all this dominance. You need to score goals, you need to put the ball at risk at the right time, and I think Scotland are defending well, balls into the box, and you know they've looked brighter in terms of going forward than England so far.
And that was a problem for England that we saw at times, certainly in the build up to the World Cup, and at times during the tournament itself. No Alessia Russo in the England side tonight. Alex Greenwood, early ball to the corner of the penalty area, and Hemp, who's got great pace, take on Kerr. Hemp twisting and turning, backwards goes the ball towards James. Caroline Weir with an interception, Scotland's number nine, her first real touch of the ball tonight, and she smuggles it out of play for an England throw. As we tick towards the quarter of an hour mark, 0-0 it remains here. England go back to the halfway line of Millie Bright, and England continue to dominate possession without seriously testing the Scotland number one Gibson.
Yeah, the tempo is all samey for England. What they need to do is, yes, those passes are good. Yes, they're trying to move Scotland about, but then it has to be quick. It has to be really quick passes on the edge of the area, because Scotland are quite happy for England to have it in front of them. They'll sit at the edge of the area, but the movement of the players and the ball has to increase at the edge of the area in England's final third.
A flurry of England fans down below us have just come into the upper tier. It's a tough walk to the back of the stand, I have to say. A steep climb. England with Bronze near side the right, forward to Hemp. Hempner with the edge of the 18-yard box. Bronze has made the underlapping run. Plenty back for Scotland. Hemp in field though to Bronze. That's a brilliant first touch. Square to Daly. Daly spins. She can't get the shot away, nor did she have the awareness to find Kelly, who was square. That little Cruyff turn from Lucy Bronze to make space for the shot. That impudent deft first touch was something special. But Scotland defend it well, and they managed to clear up over the halfway line, 0-0.
A great example of what I meant in terms of switching up the speed and the run. So Lucy Bronze did an underlap, basically. From her wing-back position, she went inside, and it was a clever little ball inside. So probably should have hit it second touch, but she... I think when you're in that position sometimes as a defender, that you don't probably think goals. I expect Lucy Bronze to think goals, but I think she thought across a pass to Rachel Daly would be better, but Scotland defended it well.
And Lucy Bronze, who has now made 20 appearances for England at World Cups, which is really quite remarkable at the age of 31. So I'm sure there may well be another World Cup in the offing for Lucy Bronze at some stage. And of course, the Euros in 2025 in Switzerland is something that I'm sure Serena Wiegmann is potentially already planning for, and the results in the Nations League determine the group stages for qualifying for Euro 2025. So this is competitive football at a level that I think suits England much more than the often, and even Serena Wiegmann alluded to this, the sometimes really pointless friendlies that we've seen them play in the past, Lucy Ward.
Yeah, it doesn't do either team any good. It doesn't do England any good. It doesn't do the other team any good.
Scotland are giving it away. Hemp plays the ball infield from the right. It's going to be hammered clear by Kerr. Nerby defending from Scotland momentarily there. Still 0-0 against England, but England on the attack again at the Stadium of Light. Floated in by Kelly, up towards Hemp once more. Away by Grimshaw. Stanway on the volley. Oh, the goalkeeper spilled it initially, but then gathered it at the second. An attempt. At times Scotland look organised tonight, but at times defensively they look full of mistakes and full of fear.
Yeah, the back four is structurally very, very sound, but as soon as you get 1v1, Nicola Doherty's just struggling at left back. I think she's probably right footed, and I think that doesn't help her if the player goes on the outside, and I think she's struggled in a few one-on-ones, but they've got away with it so far, and I think that they will grow in confidence. The longer it stays at 0-0 for Scotland, the more confident, and then the players that are world-class, like Caroline Weir, will come more into play.
More like football than anybody else on the TalkSport network, and the best daytime programming around as well, including White and Jordan, every weekday from 10 till 1. Always great to hear Simon and Jim going at it in the studio. And you can hear the outspoken White and Jordan podcast put online for you every weekday. And plenty more of that to come from Monday morning at 10. You can rejoin White and Jordan on Talk Sports. The ball is with England, and Alex Greenwood just inside Scotland territory. England playing from left to right in the first half. Greenwood, under no pressure whatsoever, will roll the ball up the far side, left-hand channel, out of play. Kelly couldn't keep it in. Scotland have a throw in their right-back position, and Scotland have got through the first 17 and a half minutes at 0-0, and in fairness to Scotland, I think they might well have expected to. Caroline Weir, the midfielder coming into the game, said this feels like a good time to play the Lionesses. And a feature of Scotland's recent improvement, Lucy, is that they're very hard to break down defensively.
Yeah, well, they look in a good shape. The shape's good. It's like a 4-2-3-1, but it's very narrow. And so basically their players are inside England's shape. So England will have it wide, and Lauren James has drifted wide. The wing-backs hold the width, Lucy Bronze and Chloe Kelly. And then the others inside just try and move Scotland about, but they're not for moving. And it's very, very difficult against that sort of organised block to get yourself in front of goal. And England are struggling with that.
Millie Bright has the ball for England. A very impressive figure, Millie Bright, the captain, of course, with Leah Williamson still unavailable due to injury. And on and off the pitch, Millie Bright has led by example. It was Bright who revealed this week that England have come to an agreement with the FA over those performance-related bonuses. They were frustrated that a deal hadn't been agreed before talks were put on hold prior to the World Cup. And Bright says the new agreement is positive and more than about bonuses, it's about England being world leaders off the pitch as well, and that is so important.
Yeah, I mean, there's momentum growing in every country. You know, we've read about Spain, we've seen what's happened with Spain. It's that same with Scotland trying to get some equality, England trying to drag the FA forward, and they've obviously done that, but that's what they deserve. You want an elite team that you've got to have elite backing, and I think it's important for every team.
Lucy Bronze drives infield for England to the middle of the Scotland half, and back it goes to Zellum. Zellum steers it wide left now to Kelly. Kelly calling the penalty area, away from McLaughlin, left-footed ball, played back towards the edge of the box, and two in white miss it entirely. James was there, Bronze was there, neither elected to go for the ball, and now Scotland on the counter. Martha Thomas driving infield from the right-hand side, Emsley forward in support, Emsley on the edge of the penalty area, Carter came across with a robust challenge, potentially a risky one, but she did get to the ball, knocks it out of play. Scotland throw deep inside England territory, the Lionesses nil, Scotland nil it remains.
Yeah, so basically England will be vulnerable when they lose it because they commit players forward, they're quite happy to leave the centre-backs high, and sometimes it's 3-on-3, then it was 3-on-2, Scotland got 2 up, but there's not really that much organisation to Scotland's on the counter, they just get the players forward.
Oh, here is Thomas in the penalty area though, and it could come to Weir, left-footed, what a brilliant stop by Earps! Instinctive reaction, diving save to our left-hand side at point-blank range, that was hammered goalwards by Caroline Weir, a fierce drive, and Earps repelled it, Lioness of the Year, and with good reason.
I'll tell you what, that is a terrific save, because Caroline Weir cannot believe that didn't go in the back of the net, because she struck it with such venom. And yet to see a replay, I don't know how close it was to Earps, but she had to react so quickly to save that, and that is the biggest chance of the game so far.
Less than 21 minutes in, and Caroline Weir very nearly scoring what would have been a memorable goal for Scotland against England. Scotland women who've only ever managed 2 victories over England in the entire history of a rivalry that dates back to the early 70s. The last of those wins was in March 2011, and the win prior to that in May of 1977. This is a result that the Lionesses, a fixture that the Lionesses rather, tend to absolutely dominate and have done over the years. But Scotland up to this point will certainly be the happier team, Lucy.
Yeah, I think both teams are showing really organised traits. So England like to control through possession, they like to control in the opposition half, keep the opposition at arm's length. I think Scotland have got away with a couple of dodgy defending, but as a group they're structured well, and then they just look with the turnover that they're going to counter with the quick players, and it's worked, and to be honest, that Weir shot should have been a goal had it not been for Mary Earps. It was an absolutely wonderful move and shot.
Fine diving save from the goalkeeper, all in bright pink to the left-hand side at the north end of the stadium here as we look at it. England have possession with Greenwood beneath the floodlights now on this vast playing surface, this slick and beautifully well-maintained playing surface here at Sunderland, who are having a good season in the Championship. We'll keep you up to date, of course, with the 8 o'clock kick-off between Birmingham and QPR. No goals as yet. Abigail Davis is there for us at St Andrews. The second that there is a goal, we will go straight to the West Midlands. And it really is the start of your sporting weekend on the network, with Luton against Wolves on Talksport 2 at 3 tomorrow, Burnley against Manchester United in the Premier League, live and exclusive, Fight Night Live tomorrow night from Wembley Arena. We'll have commentary of Zhang against Joyce. Sunday, the Sunday session takes you around the grounds for all the goals as they go in, and 2 commentaries in the Championship as well, Stoke against Hull and Sunderland against Cardiff. And we've got NFL commentary for you on TalkSport 2 on Sunday as well. 3 commentaries, back to back to back, updates from the Rugby World Cup, the Solheim Cup, the F1. If you want it, we've got it on the TalkSport network this weekend and across every sporting weekend. Here come England with Stanway. Middle of the Scotland half. Scotland defending very deep. Lots of dark blue shirts behind the ball. England in the white shirts with Hemp. 10 yards from the edge of the penalty area. Has to check back and find Bright inside the centre circle.
So what I'd say to England now is Scotland at the set. So if you start to shoot now for England, it makes Scotland have to come out and defend and engage. And that then opens the space up.
Lovely turn by James. Driving down the inside left channel. Sliding in is Grimshaw. and it's gone behind and out of play for England's third corner of the night so far. They're still yet to make the breakthrough midway through the first half.
As you would expect, Lauren James is, when it's a tight game like this, it's up to Lauren James to find herself in space, and then it's up to the England players to find her with the ball, and they've done it a few times, and they look threatening when she appears in that inside channel on the left hand side. And she's very clever. It's not about standing in the space, it's about arriving in it, and she does that very, very well.
It's Zellen wearing number four, who's gone across to take the corner. No Kira Walsh, the Barcelona player, is injured, so not involved tonight as we expected. Zellen's right footed delivery towards Daly! Fantastic header, and England leads Scotland by a goal to nil. Rachel Daly, England's number nine, darted towards the near post, thundered the header beyond the goalkeeper, who got a touch but couldn't keep it out, and terrific noise all around the sold-out Stadium of Light, the cross of St George being waved everywhere you look. England 1, Scotland 0. Rachel Daly, the goal scorer against the old enemy. But is it going to count? Well, the referee was looking towards the near side. England still celebrating. The flag was up. And I think England's celebrations are going to be cut short here. The boos of the supporters in the stadium have replaced the cheers. And the ball has been placed on the edge of the 6-yard line. And England are desperately disappointed, but for what you can only assume was some kind of infringement, a foul inside the penalty area maybe, the goal is ruled out, and we're hearing that it's been disallowed for a player in front of the goalkeeper, Gibson, and obstructing her, offside.
Interesting, that's an inch. I mean, what I would say there, Rachel Daly couldn't do any more, and that's why she's a goal scorer. So England have found it very, very difficult to unpick Scotland. Set piece, run and header, and that is what she can do. I don't think there's any, since Ellen White went, there isn't another England player that can do what she's just done there. But you'd be really disappointed if that was, if, and it's because obviously she was in front of the goalkeeper, whoever it was, the player in front of the goalkeeper, Chloe Kelly, I think it was. Just making sure that she was just putting the goalkeeper off, but then obviously it's been given offside. But that was a terrifically well-worked goal for England.
So England 0, Scotland 0. It remains the key flash point of the game so far, 26 minutes in. And Rachel Daly denied what would have been her 15th England goal, courtesy of an offside flag. Chloe Kelly in an offside position, and Scotland will be relieved. They've conceded another corner, this time on the near side of the field, won by Hemp, and maybe England can make something of this time with the score still 0-0.
Do you know what? It's woken the stadium up, and I think that's the most brilliant bit about it, because the England fans were just wanting something to light them up. And I think that, you know, when you see a goal, if you could describe it to listeners, a corner coming across and a flying header, timing and climbing of Rachel Daly, terrific header, but obviously the goalkeeper's view impeded.
Well, this corner will be an outswinger this time from Zellum. The other one was an inswinger. She drives it towards the edge of the 6-yard box, and Daly's up there again, and so too is Millie Bright. This time Scotland scramble it clear beyond the edge of the penalty area. Backwards from Zellum to the halfway line, and Carter. Everybody inside the Scotland half, bar the England goalkeeper, Mary Earps. As we tick towards the half-hour mark in this inaugural Nations League match, the first ever Nations League match that both England and Scotland have played. Still 0-0 in England's group A1 between Belgium and the Netherlands. That game approaching half-time. This one kicked off 15 minutes later. Here is Kelly for England, who are coming forward again, swarming forward towards Scotland, but at no great pace at the moment. Stanway lays the ball square towards the near side in Greenwood, whose touch is heavy. It wasn't a great pass from Stanway, not enough weight on it. Scotland breaking now. It's the front three with Hansen down the left-hand side, racing forward unchallenged. True at the back post. Hansen's low ball in, and sliding it was Martha Thomas. She only needed a touch to turn it home inside the 6-yard box, but she couldn't quite reach it, the new Tottenham striker, and it's gone behind for a goal kick to England, and it's still 0-0.
And once again, Scotland, they win the ball back, and they know the areas to exploit, so it's behind the wing backs, right? It's at the centre backs, and I think Kirsty Hansen there, she ran into, so halfway into England's half, and then she just put this diagonal ball across the floor, just inches away from Martha Thomas. It was a terrific diagonal ball, it just needed a touch in. Luckily for England, Scotland didn't get it.
We'll have coverage throughout this season of the domestic game in England, the return of the WSL, of course, which we will cover for you across the campaign with live commentaries. And it all gets back underway in just a week or so now. England have possession with James playing it wide to the left, and Kelly. Kelly driving in field to a more central position. Hemp on her outside. Kelly goes for goal, right footed, it's blocked. Drops to Daly. Now Stanway, edge of the D, thought about a shot. Sets up Bronze. Defender back was Hansen. A striker reverting to a defensive role. And she managed to hack it away before Bronze could reach it in a dangerous position inside the box. And England recycle possession and go again.
Yeah, desperate defending from Scotland. And what they've done is they've got a little bit confident. They committed players forward. And that's what England want them to do. They've done well. Series of passes got themselves in front of goal. And so they've ventured forward a bit. And England will punish them if they keep doing that. They have to stay in that compact shape.
0-0 it remains. Kelly with the cross for England. Daly's in there again, hit it away by Howard. It drops towards Stanway on the edge of the box. Stanway was caught there by Weir going for that 50-50. In fact, it wasn't Weir, it was Hansen on the near side. And Stanway just walking away rather gingerly from that 50-50. She looks down towards her right boot. Clearly there was a bit of contact between the two, completely unintended on Hansen's part, but Stanway came off worse. Now she's looking to move again.
What I would say about Scotland is they have to make the most of those big moments. So they've had Caroline Weir, a shot that she should have scored, and that one from Martha Thomas should have scored.
And Thomas is playing it through the middle towards the onrushing Grimshaw. Good interception by Greenwood. Coming across from the left centre-back position for England to the middle of the three and bailing out Millie Bright and Jess Carter, who were both caught a little flat-footed. Half an hour gone on TalkSport. England 0, Scotland nil it remains. We have 450 live commentaries for you across the course of the season, but lots of coverage of sport across the world in general as well. We'll keep you up to date with the Rugby World Cup again this weekend, the Solheim Cup, the F1 Grand Prix, and the second ODI between Ireland and England. And of course, next weekend, the great awaited return of the Ryder Cup. And on TalkSport Breakfast, every weekday morning from 6 o'clock on Thursday and Friday, Ali McCoist and Alan Brazil will be live in Rome ahead of the Ryder Cup. And we cannot wait for that. All of the build-up and all of the stories as well from the night before, no doubt. England have possession with Greenwood. She's miscontrolled. Out of play it goes. Scotland throw 10, 15 yards into England territory. You can feel the confidence of this Scotland side tonight, Lucy Ward, especially while it's still 0-0.
Yeah, and I mean, England play this way on purpose. They commit players forward on purpose. They put the ball at risk on purpose, and that's the balance that they've just got to make sure that those defenders, when they're left one-on-one, defend well, because Scotland are good in those forward areas.
Hemsley's crossing the right and it's sliced behind by Millie Bright. The ball flies into the lower tier of the North Stand into a mass of England supporters. England banners and England hoardings all around the stadium tonight. And it'll be a corner to Scotland on the far side. Their first of the game. And Caroline Weir will go across to take it. Can Scotland prove a potent threat? Aston Villa's Rachel Corsi and Leicester's Sophie Howard. The two centre-halves are both forward. Martha Thomas is a threat in the air as well, potentially. Weir to swing this one in. Headed away by Millie Bright of England. The ball drops to the corner of the penalty area now. Plenty of white shirts back for England, but that's a great turn by Thomas away from Hemp. She chips it goalwards. It's gathered by Earps inside the six-yard box.
Yeah, good play by Martha Thomas. I think it was easy in the end for her. She didn't really get enough on it, Thomas, but she a really good turn to get herself in a position where she could have that shot.
And it was promising again for Scotland, and their head coach Pedro Martinez Losa, who hasn't even left his technical area in that dark blue suit and the white trainers. He's been there the entire game so far. Not seen much of Serena Wiegman on the touchline yet. England's most successful manager. Here come England with Daly. 25 yards out, shoots right footed, and it's going to fly wide. It seemed to take an age to drift away from the right hand post. I think Gibson felt she would have had it covered anyway.
But that's what I meant by shooting. So that's the first time really that England have had that sort of shot. I think Stanway's had one. But when you start to shoot rather than try to fiddle the ball in and get in behind and across, it means that Scotland then have to jump out of their back four shape and close you down. And then that's where the gaps arise. That's where the Lauren James can get in, or Chloe Kelly can get in, or Lauren Hemp can get in. When you can be a bit clever when Scotland do come out and engage. Just makes the opposition defend differently.
Scotland trying to play the ball out from the back and they put it away. It was a poor pass and Kelly's got it edge of the D. Kelly shoots, rifles it into the back of Corsi. Now Hemp, caught on the penalty area, controlled it neatly. McLaughlin makes a good tackle though. All credit so far to Rachel McLaughlin, who's dealt well with the threat. We know the potent pace and power that Lauren Hemp possesses. She had such an impressive World Cup with three goals, including a second in the semi-final victory over Australia. But Hemp has been kept quite quiet tonight by McLaughlin. 0-0.
Yeah, they've not really found Lauren Hemp in areas where that she can hurt Scotland, because they've not really got in behind England. They are not leaving enough space in behind Scotland so that Hemp can use the pace. So she's just got to be a little bit clever about how she gets herself on the ball.
Salford Red Devils 0, Catalan Dragons 6 in the relatively early stages of our live Super League commentary tonight on TalkSport 2. You can join Mark Wilson and Paul Cook for full commentary. Just download the TalkSport app to make sure you swipe between both stations as and when you want to, as and when you need to. A big Premier League weekend over the next couple of days continues on the TalkSport network, including Burnley against Manchester United tomorrow night. Here come England with Hemp, middle of the Scotland half, dispossessed by the much taller Howard, the centre-half, and back it goes to McLaughlin. Jinx away from Kelly, backwards to Corsi. Corsi under pressure from the on-rushing Hemp, but Corsi's turned away well there. Giving the ball straight to Stanway, though. England win it back high up the pitch. Here is Daly, who's already had one goal disallowed tonight. 0-0 it remains, with Hemp teasing it backwards to Stanway again. Stanway flicks it into the penalty area. Diving header clear by Howard. We've had 35 minutes. England still looking for the breakthrough.
Yeah, you can actually see Scotland growing in confidence, and I think that that was a little bit of a shot in the arm as well when the England goal was disallowed. Scotland just ruined themselves that they'd allowed the goal to be scored from a set piece, but now they look a little bit more confident when they get the ball to feet.
And Scotland coming forward with Grimshaw, who threaded the ball neatly to the near side, the left, and Hansen, who's left of the forward three. Corner of the penalty area wearing number 10. Hansen heading for the dead ball line, then checks back with Bronze in close attention for England. Bronze sticks out a leg, got to be careful to not commit a foul in that area, inside the 18-yard box. Lucy Bronze, who gave away a penalty at the World Cup. Scotland still have it with Doherty. Doherty, the left-back, crosses in towards the chest of Thomas. Millie Bright is there for England, and Thomas has gone down. Clearly come off worse after that challenge. Everybody looks towards the Italian referee. Scotland certainly want the game stopped, and eventually, after a long look at it, Maria Sole Caputi decides to call a halt to the match, at least temporarily.
So Martha Thomas is a throwback centre-forward. So she's strong. She's quite happy to battle with the centre-back. And in that case, it was Millie Bright. The ball was... She'd already made the run. She'd come short and then she'd gone again. And then the cross came in. So she's just trying to get her body in the way in between Bright and the ball. And she's got a little bit of a shove in the back from Bright inside the area. I'm not sure that there was enough for a penalty. The referee was in a good position. But that's the sort of... So it will be a battle all night physically for Millie Bright, because Martha Thomas doesn't mind that sort of play.
03717 223344 to speak to Adam Catchell and Carlton Cole in the Sports Bar Weekender from 10, reacting to tonight's game at the Stadium of Light. The game is stopped 37 minutes in. England 0, Scotland 0 it remains. We've just seen a replay of that challenge. That's Bright on Thomas. Is that a penalty?
Yeah, that's definitely a penalty. I think Millie Bright, I don't know what she was doing, but she just nudged Thomas right in the back with the ball was absolutely nowhere near. I'm surprised that the referee, she looked like she was in a good position, but Martha Thomas is obviously winded because she got the elbow in the back, but also the ball was nowhere near. You can't do that.
Well, it's worth saying in the context of that incident and in the context of the disallowed England goal, no VAR tonight. We do have goal line technology, but no video assistant referee. 0-0 it remains. Scotland are going to temporarily be down to 10 players. The game's about to get restarted. And let's bring you the latest in the Championship at St Andrews. Birmingham against QPR. TalkSport's Abigail Davis.
Yeah, 23 minutes on the clock here. Remarkably, it is still Blues 0, QPR 0. We had a remarkable chance for the home side a couple of moments ago. The ball was floated into the area from the left. Steve Cook's attempted clearance looked destined for the top left corner. Begovic tried but couldn't quite save it. But Sam Field made a sublime recovery run, hooking the ball away, a bicycle kick to prevent the home side from taking the lead. So it remained goalless here, 23 minutes gone.
Thanks, Abigail. Birmingham City 0, QPR 0, and Birmingham will go into the playoff places tonight ahead of the Championship weekend if they pick up a victory. We've got two live commentaries on TalkSport 2 from the Championship for you on Sunday. Stoke against Hull, Sunderland against Cardiff here at the Stadium of Light. England 0, Scotland 0 in the North East this evening. 38 and a half minutes played. Zellum's reverse ball. Bronze! Brilliant header! This time the flag stays down! And Lucy Bronze heads the Lionesses into the lead late in the first half. That dynamic run deep to the far post, picked up beautifully by Zellum, and Bronze beat Gibson, and England leads Scotland by a goal to nil.
Tell you what a brilliant move that was by England. It's all about the deep run inside from Lucy Bronze, and she wasn't picked up. By the time she was picked up, it was too late. She'd got beyond. Terrific ball in, I think, from Zellum, and what a header that was. Brilliant goal from England.
Lucy Bronze with her 13th goal in Lionesses colours, and it was a lovely downward header made by the pass, floated forward by Katie Zellum, and England score a fine goal, and this time the header into the back of the net will count for Serena Wiegmann and the Lionesses. 40 minutes gone, they lead the old enemy of Scotland by a goal to nil. We've just seen a replay of the goal on our monitor in the commentary position, and it was a delightful ball from Katie Zellum of Manchester United.
Yeah, Lucy Bronze timed a run diagonal from out to in behind Scotland, had left a little bit of space, probably the first time in the game they've left a little bit of space in behind, but it's all about the run and it's all about the ball. First thing Lucy Bronze did after she'd headed it in was look round at the assistant referee. It's not offside, it was a really well-timed run, and I think Lauren James had had it in the left-hand side, and then she ran from deep just about onside. I think even if VAR had been on, I think she would have been offside, but it was a close one. But it was a flying header. I don't think we see many flying headers, but really well worked from England's point of view. And it's been tough for England. They've huffed and puffed at times, but they've got themselves in front.
She had both feet off the ground as she headed that beyond the goalkeeper Gibson, and it bounced just in front of the Scotland number one, and that made it such a difficult header to save. And England lead by a goal to nil, and Serena Wiegmann led the celebrations on the touchline with a pump of the fist. Do England deserve it, Lucy?
Well, I think that they've had a lot of control of this game. I think the big moments have come for Scotland. I don't think they've made the most of them, and you sort of think when it happens two or three times, they should have had a penalty. And when they don't make the most of them, you've always got that threat of England. If they've got the ball, they've got more chance of scoring. And I know, I just think that the movement from Bronze, the ball from Zellum was absolutely brilliant. And you could probably say that they'll go in thinking, well, we deserve that because we've had most of the ball, but Scotland will be ruined the fact that they weren't already in front.
We have seen Lucy Bronze score memorable goals from headers in the past for England, including the semi-finals and the win over Sweden at the Euros, which feels such an age ago now. Not much over a year ago. And England leads Scotland thanks to a Lucy Bronze header here at the Stadium of Light. The ball is knocked out of play by Scotland's Rachel McLaughlin. A poor clearance up the far side right channel. England have a throw that Alex Greenwood will take.
What happens when you've got Lucy Bronze as a wing-back rather than a full-back means that she's got the licence to get up the pitch. So when it's that far post run, she's a weapon for England in terms of getting in there. And that sort of ball is exactly what she needed because she'll attack it.
Scotland have had their chances, as Lucy has said, but they haven't taken them, and they've been made to pay by England, who are looking to roar again after defeat in the World Cup final just over a month ago to Spain. All of that heartache in Sydney, Australia on that very disappointing night for everybody involved with the Lionesses, but you have to move on quickly in football, and England are doing just that. Here is Hemp parading down the right-hand side and driving it field away from Kerr. Oh, Hemp wanted the run of Bronze on the overlap to her right. She was expecting Bronze to be there. Played the ball into a completely open area, but Bronze had checked her run and it went straight out of play.
Actually, that's a really good example of how well-drilled England are. So Hemp didn't even have to look there because she thought that Lucy Bronze should have been there. She wasn't because she'd gone and she'd followed inside. But that's how they practice, that sort of drilled. If the one of the nines has got the ball and they're driving towards goal, then you've always got that overlap, and just didn't look very good, but that was part of their patterns of play, England.
Half-time in the other game in England's group, Belgium 0, Netherlands 0. And elsewhere in League A, in the Nations League, Wales 1-0 down away at Iceland late in their match. That kicked off at 7 o'clock. The ball is on the halfway line with Caroline Weir of Scotland. A heavy touch and a throw for England right in between the two dugouts, and there's quite a distance between the dugouts and the field of play here at the Stadium of Light. The England crest right by the halfway line, the three lions. And here is Stanway for England playing it wide to the near side. And Bronze, the goal scorer for England, who lead 1-0. 90 seconds of normal time remaining. Lauren Hemp marauds in field. Away from two in the dark blue and white of Scotland. Back it goes to Greenwood, on to James. Lovely touch out wide to Chloe Kelly. England are building here, plenty in the middle. Kelly back to Greenwood. First time left-footed cross is a poor one. It could still reach Hemp in the area. Couldn't get it under control. Smuggled upfield by Kerr for Scotland. And good play by Carter to get in front of Thomas and send it back to Earps, the goalkeeper.
I'll tell you what, if you were a Scotland supporter or a Scotland player, you would be gutted about that. When you look back on the half, the penalty, that should have been a penalty. Yep. Scotland should have had a penalty. England had a goal disallowed, and it did look like there was somebody in the way of the goalkeeper and in an offside position. But that, when we see the replay, that was certain penalty. And it's difficult. When you're a team like Scotland, it's a balance. How often and when do you put the ball at risk? When do you put players forward? And they started to do that, and that's when England then scored the goal that counted for Lucy Bronze. But they've looked all right, Scotland, at times.
Daly's made an interception on Doherty, though, and suddenly England have three forward. Daly down the right, first time cross towards the far post, and a brilliant flying header for 2-0 to England. It was a delightful piece of play, surging down the right-hand side when Rachel Daly, she flung in the cross to the middle of the penalty area, and Lauren Hemp with a flying header beyond the goalkeeper into the back of the net. Two fine England goals tonight. 2-0 they lead Scotland.
And do you know what? That was all about Lauren Hemp wanting it more. That was all about Lauren Hemp attacking the ball. It's an absolutely terrific ball over from the right-hand side. I was listening to Drive today on Talksport, and Goldstein and Darren Bent were talking about they don't see flying headers anymore, and that we've just seen two flying headers from crosses, and Hemp absolutely threw herself in front of the defender and got to it first, and it absolutely powered into the back of the net. What a goal that was.
Lauren Hemp, one of the smaller players on the field, but rose like a salmon above the Scotland back line to thump in a header beyond the goalkeeper, and it's 2-0 to England into first half stoppage time.
Really bad time to concede from Scotland's point of view, because like I say, they were doing all right. England were frustrated, but they just attacked a little bit quicker when Scotland were out of shape, and they just ventured out Scotland when they got a little bit more confident, and that just is heaven for England because it opens the spaces up.
Minutes into first half added time, England 2 Scotland 0, live on Talk Sport in the Women's Nations League, the first such game for either side, and Hemp rose beautifully there to meet a fine cross from Daly. The two assists that we've seen tonight have been excellent from an England perspective. And England in trouble as they've given it away. Greenwood straight to Caroline Weir of Scotland. Weir with her back to goal. That was fortunate for England there. Opportunity for Emsley to drive into the penalty area, pull it back across, and it's touched in off the post. And it's Scotland who've got a route back into the game. Kirsty Hansen, I think, got there first to poke it in beyond Earps, off the woodwork. The goalkeeper was flat-footed. England's back four, even more so. And Scotland, with the final kick of the first half, have got themselves right back into the game. And you have to say, deservedly so, England 2, Scotland 1 is the half-time score. England, who went into a two-goal lead, courtesy of fine headers from Lucy Bronze and Lauren Hemp, but Scotland, who competed well throughout, have got themselves a foothold right at the end of the first half. The pull back towards the edge of the six-yard box, England defenders nowhere, England already having been careless in possession in the build-up to that goal, and it looked like the number 10 Hansen, who just nipped in front of Thomas to poke it in off the post and make the half-time score an intriguing one on TalkSport. England 2, Scotland 1.
Well, that's made it interesting, Lucy Ward. You just said Scotland have conceded at the worst possible time, and then England went and beat them to that.
Yeah, and do you know what? Scotland Scotland have been threatening. And what I mean, when England throw bodies forward, they leave gaps. They do it on purpose. They take risks in the way that they play. But Scotland have got the players to hurt England. And we'd seen glimpses of it. Weir should have scored. Great save from Mary Earps. And Martha Thomas should have scored. It was a really great ball. And then there was a mess in England's defence. And Kirsty Hansen puts it in the back of the net, and probably no more than they deserve. If they'd have gone in 2-0 down, they'd have gone, well, hang on a minute, how's that happened? And should have had a penalty. So they're in it, Scotland.
Yeah, they really are. And actually, they're causing England's back line quite a few problems, I would say. We saw the fantastic save from Mary Earps, from Caroline Weir. And then just then, Alex Greenwood giving the ball away. The last person on earth you want to be giving the ball away to in the six-yard box is Caroline Weir.
Yeah, Caroline Weir is such a clever player. So she positioned, I mean, she has to do a lot of defending, but she positions herself when it gets into the final third that when Scotland win it back, that they look for her, and then they look wide, and then she gets herself forward, then Thomas is joining, then Hansen is joining, the Emsley's joining, all of them have pace. Caroline Weir's got real good game craft, so she chooses the right pass or shot, and we've seen the ferocity of that shot that Earp saved. So I'd look at Scotland and think they'll be disappointed, but glad that it's just a one goal difference now going into half time.
Yeah, most definitely. In terms of the Lionesses though, the opening 20 minutes or so, we just didn't see enough of a clinical edge from them, which was a problem during the World Cup as well.
Yeah,
they've got to be better at that.
Yeah, and they're all and the better that England get, and the better that teams will defend, or the more teams will defend against them. So you have to find an answer. One of it's being clinical. Two of it is choosing the right moments to put the ball at risk. And what I mean that is put a ball into the final third that you might not get on the end of. And I think the reason why it opened up is that Scotland got a little bit confident, got a little bit cocky because they've done, and I don't mean that derogatory, I mean that they got themselves in good position, should have scored. So they've ventured forward, left side. So Kirsty Hansen wasn't tucked in as much on the left-hand side, just leaves Doherty open a bit on left back. And so it just meant that pass can be played in. And the goals are pretty similar, but from either side. And I think that they just came from the fact that Scotland just taking more chances.
Yeah, and the chance that you took, that Rachel Daly took by robbing the ball on the right-hand side, he said. But you mentioned in commentary, both of those balls in were absolutely pinpoint. Katie Zellum's first and foremost was an absolute delight, beautifully put into the box. And then Rachel Daly, I actually thought she was aiming for Lauren James. She completely missed Lauren James. I hadn't even spotted Lauren Hemp running in.
I mean, the thing about the women's game is that it's only recently, I played with a great header of the ball in Karen Walker, and I remember going to play with her at Doncaster Bells and thinking, I'm about 2 inches taller than her. Why am I not dominating in the air? And that changed my mindset, and it's about attacking. And what Lauren Hemp does, she just attacked the ball. She got there in front of the defender, and that's why she scored. And Lucy Bronze is a little bit different. She comes from deep. She times it well. Great ball in. And it's a difficult ball for Zellum to play. But flying headers, both of them. But that was because the space had opened up. The ball was very, very accurate. And the players were willing to attack the ball.
And I'm loving Lauren Hemp in this more centering role. You know, we're used to seeing her flying down the wings. But I feel like she's more effective here.
Yeah. Well, she's more involved. I mean, the thing is, when you play wide, if you get fed the ball, then it's very, very difficult. So Dean Saunders, for instance, he will say that he played either left... Where you playing today, he'll say left idiot or right idiot, meaning you don't hardly get the ball. But she now, she's such a good player in terms that she can wriggle free, she's very strong, she can find the gaps, and she is a goal scorer when she gets in front of goal. And we've seen tonight that she can certainly do that.
She's intelligent as well.
She
and she
is.
Builds the play. She sees the space.
Yep.
She plays the weighted balls as well, and then gets herself into a goal scoring opportunity. And clearly, you know, we talked in the build up about Serena Wiegmann's tactical nous. She's utilizing the players' skills that they have in different positions, using that versatility to their benefit, which is ultimately to England's benefit.
Yeah, and Serena Wiegmann, and she has her own mind, and she can do a plan B. And we saw in the World Cup a coach that we would never expect to rip up the tactical sheet that she had. She had to do it because it became, the 4-2-3-1 became stale. After losing Kira Walsh, she had to play three at the back. And then these players, she's probably not surprised, but a little bit surprised at Lauren Hemp in terms of, she knows what she can get from Lauren Hemp in a wide position. She knows that she's front foot, but all of a sudden she's finding little pockets of space. She's intelligent enough to leave the space for Lauren James as well. And then everybody's attracted to Lauren James, which then gives Hemp space. It, honestly, the way that these girls click into what Serena Wiegmann wants is very, very clever, and it's just that sort of game craft that that these players have.
We saw a bit of the brightness of Lauren James in the early kind of 10 minutes, but she's been relatively quiet, I would say.
Yeah, I mean, I think that Scotland got on top of her in terms of Sam Kerr got a little bit closer to her, which she needed to do. It was about Lauren James finding her own space, but it's very difficult when you're playing against a narrow and compact shape. However, and I will say this till the end of time, if I had what Lauren James had, I would just get on that ball and just really sort of run at players. Nobody could get the ball off her. Shoot, she's got a hammer of a foot, either foot. But it's like she plays within herself, and I don't know whether that's because she's quite young or I don't know what it is, but she has got unbelievable potential that she could run any game that she plays in just because of what she can do when she's on the ball. But she's, you know, she's found space, she's done a few clever little runs, you know, she's linked play up very, very well, but I still think there's more to come from her in this game.
Yeah, I agree with you on that. And by the way, you know, we trademarked earlier on your Pickles comment. I should also trademark on behalf of TalkSport's Sam Matterface, Mary Queen of Stops, because during the World Cup, everybody came up with that. But Sam Matterface, I'm pretty certain, came up with that first. She couldn't prevent Scotland from pulling one back in this match, though. It is England 2, Scotland 1 going into the second half. Let's find out what's going on in the Championship, shall we? Birmingham City against Queen's Park Rangers coming up to half-time there. How's it going, Abigail Davis?
Yeah, 5 minutes left in this opening half. It does still remain goalless. There haven't been too many clear-cut chances in this one, but having survived a scare when field cleared off the line, QPR have upped the urgency, upped their intensity since then. Paul Smith trying his luck from the edge of the area when he found himself in acres of space, but it was collected with relative ease. Dykes has also glanced ahead a wider the target from a free kick. For the home side, though, Anderson tried his luck from a tight angle after a lovely run into the box, but couldn't really test Begovic at his near post. As we approach half-time, it is Birmingham who look to be in the ascendancy now. 5 minutes of this opening half left. It is Birmingham 0, QPR 0.
Thank you very much, Abby. Don't forget, here on TalkSport, it's not just football updates we give you, live commentary that we give you either. We'll have updates from the Rugby World Cup going over on in France at the moment. England play Chile this weekend, and tomorrow night TalkSport is bringing you exclusive commentary of the heavyweight rematch between Zhilai Zhang and Joe Joyce live from Wembley Arena. Our expert team is including presenters Adam Cattrall and Gareth A. Davis, commentator Andy Clark, former super bantamweight champion Spencer Oliver, and Hall of Famer Carl Froch. What a lineup that is. The fight is going to be live and exclusive from 7 o'clock tomorrow night on TalkSport 2 before switching over to TalkSport at 10 p.m. for the main event. While also, you need to make sure you head over to the TalkSport Boxing YouTube channel to stay across all of the build-up we have to fight night and join on the night for the watch-along with the team as well, which is unmissable. This is kickoff on TalkSport. England leads Scotland by 2-1 in their opening Nations League match. Second half action coming up from the Stadium of Light next.
Tackling the mountain of washing up from dinner? Put a twist on the ordinary with Oreo cookie and shake things up. Whether it's the original Oreo cookie or the vanilla and raspberry flavor twist, there are endless ways to enjoy them. How about building an Oreo cookie pyramid while tonight's dinner is cooking? Or wind down by twisting open your Oreo cookie and scraping the cream for some relaxing ASMR in between meetings. So go on, what's your Oreo twist?
The future is unpredictable at times. But at the Open University in Wales, you can fit study around your life with the experts in distance learning. And on our part-time courses, you could get up to £4,500 of funding towards living costs. Now, suddenly, your options are open. Register by the 7th of September to get started. The Open University. The future is open. Eligibility rules apply for financial support.
The Monopoly game is back at McDonald's. And guess what? It's still twice as nice. Because with double peel, you can peel on pack, then peel again on the McDonald's app to win prizes like brand new mini electrics, lovely McDonald's food, HP Omen gaming laptops, TUI holiday vouchers, £1,000 in cash, plus tons of other incredible prizes. 18 plus, UK only. Selected items. Subjects and serving times and availability. End 17th of October. Gameplay and price claims may require McDonald's app. See mcdrules.co.uk.
The rewards points went in 2x2. Hurrah! Hurrah!
The rewards points went in 2x2. Hurrah! Hurrah! The rewards points went in 2x2 when you're shopping and your fuel too. And they all went onto your card so you'll get lovely rewards.
Enjoy double BP Me rewards points on everything from filling your tank to filling your basket. Plus, get double rewards points on BP Ultimate Fuels with active technology.
Hurrah!
BP, here for all of life's journeys. T's and C's apply. Available at participating dealer-owned BP stores only. For details, see bpmerewards.co.uk/double points.
Keep your place safe. Set timeouts to always ensure you take a break when you feel like you need it. Set reality checks so you know exactly how long you've been playing. And set deposit limits to help control what you spend. Stay golden with BetMGM. Play responsibly.
18 plus.
It's back for another year. Don't miss the incredible chance to win a van with Howdens. From now until the 28th of October, choose from a huge range of quality kitchens, accessories and brilliant offers. Spend £300 on any order, including at least one Lamona appliance, and you could win a brand new Ford Transit. It's open to all UK trade account holders, so visit your local Howdens now. Excludes VAT at 20%. T's and C's apply.
COVID-19. Coronavirus.
The pandemic.
Everyone experienced it.
But no one quite like you.
The lockdowns.
The video calling.
The life-changing moments.
What you went through then.
What you're still going through now.
Every difficult memory.
Has a different story to tell.
That's why.
Every story matters.
There's still time. Share your experience of the pandemic to inform the UK COVID-19 inquiry. And help shape the future. Search Every Story Matters.
Want to build the bet you want in seconds? With Unibet's Bet Builder, you're on. Add shots, corners, cards, and more. And increase your odds with Bet Builder Rackers, combining bet builders across multiple games and sports. Download the Unibet app or visit unibet.co.uk and get a Bet Builder boost every day. Unibet. You're on. 18 plus, begambleaware.org, pre-match only, max stake £10 minimum, combined odds of 4-1 and 3 selections. T's and C's apply.
Feel the passion, feel the pride.
What a finish!
The UEFA Women's Nations League on Talksport.
Zellens reverse ball, Bronze! Brilliant header! This time the flag stays down! And Lucy Bronze heads the Lionesses into the lead. Daly down the right, first time cross towards the far post, and a brilliant flying header for 2-0 to England. Drive into the penalty area, pull it back across, and it's touched in off the post. And it's Scotland who've got a route back into the game. Kirsty Hansen, I think, got there first to poke it in beyond Earps, off the woodwork. The goalkeeper was flat-footed. England's back four, even more so. And Scotland, with the final kick of the first half, have got themselves right back into the game. And you have to say, deservedly so, England 2, Scotland 1 is the half-time score.
This is Kickoff on TalkSport. I'm Faye Carruthers. Thanks for sharing your Friday night with us for some international football. The Women's Nations League, not disappointing so far. England and Scotland both back out, both in huddles here at the Stadium of Light, ready for a massive 45 minutes. Scotland got themselves right back into this one with the last kick of the first half. What do they have up their sleeves for the second? Let's find out with Lucy Ward and Joe Shenham.
And Scotland dreaming of a first victory over England in 12 and a half years, and only their third in the history of this fixture. You have to go back to May 1977 for the other victory that Scotland have picked up over the Lionesses, who have been absolutely dominant in this fixture over years and years. And it is England who lead by 2-1, with the second half about to get off and underway here at a sold-out Stadium of Light. Lots of spectators coming back to their seats. Ahead of the second period, it'll be Scotland playing from left to right. Dark blue shirts, white shorts and red socks. And England from right to left in the white shirts, blue shorts and white socks. I'll give you the two sides in full. No changes at half-time. Mary Earps in goal for England, with Carter, Bright and Greenwood the centre-halves. Bronze, the goal scorer, or one of the goal scorers, and Kelly the wing-backs. Stanway and Zellum in midfield, with Hemp the other goal scorer, and James in support of Daly up front. Daly, who saw a goal ruled out in the first period. Scotland, meanwhile, have Gibson in goal. McLaughlin, the right back, with Howard and Corsi, the centre halves. And the left back is Doherty. Kerr, Grimshaw and Weir are the three in midfield. Hanson, the Scotland goalkeeper, in support of Emsley and Martha Thomas. As England goalkeeper, all in pink, Mary Earps clears up towards the midway point of her own half. One terrific save in the first half for Mary Earps. England, though, will be disappointed with the manner of the goal they conceded. And here's Caroline Weir going for goal from range again, having juggled it forward. And really, the shot was a poor one, when maybe a pass through the middle to Martha Thomas would have been a better option. It's England 2, Scotland 1, live on TalkSport. And alongside me in the commentary box is Lucy Ward.
It's quite interesting. I think that the start of this game, I think Scotland were a little bit wobbly in terms of the defence, and I think that it lulled England into a false sense of security, and then they just got the foot into the game, Scotland, and they're actually countering very well, which you've seen it. We've seen Kirsty Hansen get in behind Lucy Bronze a number of times in the first half. I think that when they lose it further up the pitch, I think they're positioned well to win it back, so like a counter-press for Scotland. And I think England at times have been a little bit sloppy, and they've not really been as clinical as they needed to be in the final third, and now all of a sudden it's a game, and England have to work really, really hard to make sure they get the win.
2-1 to England here, 90 seconds into the second half. Let's get half time in the Championship at St Andrews. Talk Sports, Abigail Davis.
Yeah, half time, it's Birmingham 0, QPR 0, in a game of very few clear-cut chances. It's Birmingham City via the QPR defence who'll feel they should hold the lead here. QPR's best opportunity coming when Chair tried his luck from a really tight angle. His effort was parried into the path of Armstrong by John Ruddy, but the forward headed over from close range. At the other end of the pitch, an acrobatic goal line clearance from Sam Field spared his teammate Steve Cook's blushes, as the defender's attempted clearance almost ended up in the back of his own net. For the Blues, Stansfield's close control and sublime footwork has seen his influence grow every time he drifts out to the right hand side, but at half time it remains goalless here.
Thanks, Abigail. And England 2, Scotland 1 here in the inaugural UEFA Women's Nations League. Lots of live football to come over the course of the weekend on the network, including Luton against Wolves tomorrow on TalkSport 2 at 3 on TalkSport, our regular Around the Ground service, Game Day Live with Adrian Durham, and a classified results check after the full-time whistle. 8 o'clock tomorrow night, Burnley against Manchester United. Huge game for Erik ten Hag at Turf Moor. We'll have it live for you on TalkSport. Here is Stanway for England. Inside right channel, back to Lucy Bronze. Quite a tepid start to the second half up to this point, but Daly's got it down the right-hand channel. Back infield to Zellum. Zellum's touch forward isn't a good one, and it's hammered away by Scotland by Kerr. Up downfield towards Martha Thomas, beneath the floodlights and the dark skies ahead. Millie Bright is there with a cushion header. England win it back straight away, Lucy Ward.
Yeah, I'm looking at Rachel Daly. She looks really, really sharp and bright up in that forward position. We've talked about Lauren Hemp as well, but I just think England just need to up the tempo. You know, Scotland are not making it easy for them, because they can attack when they win the ball back, and they're defending very, very well, and that goal just before half time will have given them a little bit more confidence as well. I do think Pedro Losa, the Scotland manager, who used to be Arsenal manager, I think he seems to be better suited to international management. I think at Arsenal he got himself a little bit bogged down with just bringing loads of midfielders into that Arsenal team and with tactics. But I think because of the time he has to work with the players, these players look like they're responding to the way that he wants them to play. So it looks like a good match.
Well, there were six unbeaten coming into tonight. Scotland and Pedro Martinez Losa have worked really hard to make the country's fortunes move further forward. 23rd in the world, Scotland, in the world rankings. Lucy Bronze with an early cross for England towards Daly. Plays it backwards to Hemp. First time shot, just wide of the far post. She drilled it firm and low and true with that powerful left foot. Goalkeeper Gibson was rooted to the spot, but it went just wide of the left-hand post, and it's still England 2, Scotland 1.
Now, when you're playing two up front, so you've got Daly and Hemp, and you've got Lauren James and Stanway just backing them up behind. When you do that, you want your two up front to work together. So the ball played long into Rachel Daly. Great little touch off for Lauren Hemp to have a shot, and that's good, and I think that Serena Wiemer will be happy about that. You've got to get connections all over the pitch.
5 minutes into the second half on Talk Sport. So much football to come over the course of the weekend. Lauren James has won it back on the edge of the penalty area for England. She curls it! Again, it's just a couple of yards wide. Lauren James is so menacing and so dangerous from that sort of range. We saw her score a couple of stunning goals at the World Cup, in which England reached the final and were beaten by Spain. Wasn't too far away from scoring England's third tonight.
Yeah, that's where I want Lauren James, picking the ball up, running from out to in to the edge of the area and then trying to curl and score, and that's where she is very, very dangerous. More of that for me.
2-1 though. Scotland, the old enemy for the Lionesses, are still very much in the game, and they're playing towards the end where there are plenty of Scotland fans who've made the trip across the border to the northeast of England tonight. Lots of blue and white saltires behind the goal to the right-hand side, and Scotland fans in the dark blue shirts, England regalia and banners all around the rest of the stadium. Jess Carter has the ball inside right channel. That's a lovely pass forward towards Hemp, who's got the pace to beat the defender to it. Hemp's a long way from goal. Edge of the penalty area, lays it square towards Daly. Well intercepted by Kerr, hammered away by Doherty for Scotland. England win the ball back straight away. Stanway squared infield to Zellum. Huge playing surface as we look down from our commentary position, right at the very back of the West Stand, three tiers up, just to the right of the halfway line. Sliding in is Grimshaw with the mint green boots on. England have it back, and Kelly takes the throw and gets it back from Greenwood straight away. Wins another throw off McLaughlin, and England do look dangerous in this second half.
Yeah, that ball over the top to Lauren Hemp. She's that quick that actually nobody was within sort of 10 or 15 yards in terms of England players, and they're the sort of runs that you need from her, just to stretch play, just opens up space behind as well.
6.5 minutes gone in the second period. England lead by the odd goal in three, and remember, the Nations League is important to England for a qualification for the Olympics. Team GB's qualification dependent on England's results, and the group stages for the Euros, which are due to be held in Switzerland in 2025. So there is real importance these days now about fixtures in and around major tournaments. Here is Thomas for Scotland, chipping the ball to the left, and the goal scorer, Hansen. Hansen beaten to it by a retreating Lucy Bronze, but England through Carter have given the ball away. Stanway miscontrolled. Emsley down the Scotland right, the near side of the field, driving into the penalty area. Great low ball in, cut up by Millie Bright at the near post. She did well. Scoop further clear by Greenwood beneath the lights, and England have it back with Daly, but she's midway into her own half. There wasn't a single white shirt inside Scotland territory there, and England have to hold possession, leading 2-1.
So what Scotland are doing is that they're exploiting, when Lucy Bronze gets herself forward, they're exploiting that space, Kirsty Hansen, and again Lucy Bronze just managed to get back, but Hansen has got the pace and she's direct, and that's a real threat for Scotland.
We have a busy weekend, not just on TalkSport, but on TalkSport 2 as well. Two championship commentaries and three NFL commentaries on Sunday for you. And live right now on TalkSport 2, halftime in the Super League. Salford Red Devils 2, Catalan Dragons 8. England have a player down on the near side. It's Lauren Hemp. And I think the referee might call on the physio here. So commentary on TalkSport 2 of the Super League, and the best way to stay across all the action this weekend, make sure you download our TalkSport app. You can swipe between stations at your leisure. And we've got bonus boxing for you tomorrow night. Fight Night Live on TalkSport, Zhang against Joyce, that very much anticipated heavyweight rematch live from Wembley Arena. Hemp is back on her feet and back on the field. England restart the game with Carter on the halfway line. Now Stanway dispossessed by the tenacious Caroline Weir, both former teammates at Manchester City. Hemp looking to force her way through the middle, but she's blocked off by Howard. Lauren Hemp's been quite quiet tonight, Lucy.
I tell you what, Caroline Weir is such a good player. So not only when she gets the ball, we've talked about that, but the position that she puts herself in to press, and she just caught Stanway out. She knows that Stanway likes to have a few touches, and she just nicked it off her, and she's a real threat for Scotland as well going forward.
Belgium 1, Netherlands 1 in the other game in England's Nations League Group A1. England travel to the Netherlands on Tuesday, and then they are back at home to face Belgium on the 27th of October at the King Power Stadium, Leicester City. We'll have commentary of that game on the TalkSport network, and plenty of coverage across the season, of course, of the WSL as well. Well, the game has suddenly reached walking pace. We've had these couple of mini stoppages, and the atmosphere in the stands isn't quite as raucous as it was certainly late in the first half when England scored the two goals, the one back for Scotland right on half time. And it's fascinatingly poised 10 minutes into the second period.
Yeah, and most of these players have not started the season yet, and I think you take that into account as the game goes on. You just, I think Serena Wiegmann will be well aware of that, and making sure that she doesn't risk injury to her players as well.
Hansen for Scotland, corner of the penalty area, through for Thomas, the angle is tight, Bright came across, got nothing on it in the end, she didn't have to. The physicality of the challenge on Thomas was enough, and the Tottenham striker for Scotland could only knock it out of play for a goal kick.
Yeah, there's nobody in the middle either, so even if Martha Thomas had managed to get across, there was nobody there apart from England defenders. But again, it looks promising from Scotland. They'll take a lot of confidence from the way that they're performing tonight, I think. I think that they managed to get themselves back into the game at the end of the first half, and they've just got to take enough risk now in the second half, because if they bomb players forward, then England will hurt them.
You're absolutely right about the schedule though, Lucy. Football's organisers have got to do something about it. Here comes Scotland on the attack again. Cross to the far post from Hansen, behind her three teammates in the dark blue shirts, and even Kerr can't keep it in. Furthest to the right on the near side, Emsley was stretching, but it's gone out of play for a throw to England in the left back position. And Serena Wiegmann has alluded to her frustrations with the schedule, because the WSL season is about to start and it's only been 33 days since England played in a World Cup final.
Yeah, I do think that these players at some point will struggle during the season, whether it's a start. And the problem you've got is that you're risking injury, and we've seen the spate of ACL injuries and serious injuries to players, and it's just about that playing too much at times.
Hemp is raiding down the left-hand side. She's already scored one goal for England tonight. She's held up this time by McLaughlin. McLaughlin does well, makes a tackle. Loose ball drops to Chloe Kelly, England's hero with that famous goal in the Euros final. England's most important goal at a senior team level, you have to say, since 1966. And heartache for England in the recent World Cup final in Australia. Kelly's delivery from the left-hand side. Daly swung at it, got a touch on it, but couldn't divert it goalwards. The loose ball is cleared away by Doherty into touch. England throw far side at the base of the East Stand, and England fans waving the flags again.
Yeah, well, Rachel Daly is just being told to play the width of the six-yard box so that any ball into the box, she's attacked, and she's so threatening in front of goal, and that's exactly where England want her. So they've got to get the ball in better, and that was a really good cross from the left-hand side.
As we tick towards the hour mark, and England are going to make a change here, their first change of the game, and Chloe Kelly is leaving the field. And we'll have more than one or two boos and whistles I heard from some of the England fans there, as Kelly eventually gets a big cheer as she leaves the field. In fact, maybe what I'm hearing were not boos and whistles, they were cheers for Ella Toon. Ella Toon, who's going to come on now for England. Well, I should have checked the number on the back of the shirt, Lucy, there.
Yeah, I do think that Serena Wiegmann, this is all about that they monitor the players so well, so they know how much load that they've had, physical load, what zone they're in, how the heart rate is, and it's a constant. They're constantly looking and monitoring these girls, and I think that's the reason why Russo's not playing, and it's just about balancing that and making sure that you don't put the players at risk.
Ella Toon, who scored a wonderful opening goal for England in the World Cup semi-final against Australia, which we brought you live on TalkSport. It's England 2, Scotland 1. In the Nations League, England had possession at a sold-out Stadium of Light. Big steep drop to the touchline below, where Serena Wiegmann stands alone in the technical area. Hands behind her back in a pink and blue puffer jacket. England on the attack with a number 10, James, taking on McLaughlin. Couple of step-overs, works the ball back to Daly. Daly delivers high, right-footed. Bronze arriving at the far post. Hemp tries a bicycle kick. James tries to scrap for the second ball, and Hemp's foot was high. And Howard's gone down inside the penalty area, and I think the referee has certainly given a free kick for that audacious effort from Lauren Hemp, which could have been dangerous.
Yeah, as soon as you got a high foot, you've got to make sure you connect with the ball. But I just noticed Rachel Daly's come out to the left hand. I've just been talking about how dangerous she is in the width of the goal, and then she's been moved out to replace Chloe Kelly on the as left wing back. And I just think you just lose a little bit from this team when you've not got a proper goal scorer in front of goal. I think Lauren James has gone up front with Lauren Hemp, so probably more ball into feet and just trying to find a little bit of space rather than ball into the box and someone attacking it.
Wales beaten tonight in the Women's Nations League at Iceland by 1-0. That also in Nations League A. Ball back from Carter to the England goalkeeper, Earps, away to our right. England 2, Scotland 1, an hour gone. And Mexican waves in the crowd at the Stadium of Lights.
That's not a good sign. That is not a good sign.
It's making its way round from the stand to the left into the main stand, which is where we are. Anybody going to get on their feet in the press box?
No.
I don't think so. I've got people shaking their heads next to me, that's for sure. But I tell you what, the crowd are getting involved in their thousands, that's for sure.
So that means the players are just going to raise the tempo a bit on the pitch.
And forward by McLaughlin for Scotland. A poor touch by Greenwood. A cross came bright in front of Emsley. Now that there was a deflection there, and the assistant with that chequered flag is signalling goal kick. It was a rare mistake by Alex Greenwood in the first half for the Scotland goal that has them back in the game, Lucy Wall.
Yeah, it was, and I think at times England have been a little bit loose in possession in the first half. I don't know whether they thought that it was going to be a little bit easier. I'm sure that wasn't the message from the management, but because they had a lot of control of the first 20 minutes, I just think they thought that the game was going to be a lot easier than it was, and then as soon as Scotland got a foothold in it and a bit more confidence, I think they've come more into it. But the tempo has certainly slowed down in the second half.
A Friday night football on Talksport, the beginning of your sporting weekend, including Burnley against Manchester United, live commentary tomorrow night. And Talksport breakfast next week, by the way, on Thursday and Friday morning from 6 a.m. in particular, is going to be absolutely unmissable because Ali McCoist and Alan Brazil are live in Rome ahead of the 2023 Ryder Cup with all of the build-up. That's TalkSport breakfast from 6 every weekday morning on TalkSport. Scotland have possession deep inside the England half. Emsley with the lime green boots, twisting and turning. Couldn't thread it through to Hansen. Lucy Bronze will dink it away. Poor ball straight to Hansen again. Scotland in an attacking area. Hansen hangs up the high cross. Thomas with the downward header straight at Earps. And Thomas, had she headed it either side of the England goalkeeper, might have caused the Lionesses a big problem. England 2-1.
I tell you what, Kirsty Hansen playing well again on that left-hand side. Again, a little bit of sloppiness in defence. Lucy Bronze on that right-hand side and allowed Hansen a ball into the box. And that's where she's good. Thomas getting ahead on it. She just couldn't get enough purchase on it.
England very careless, playing the ball out defensively there, and Jess Carter has knocked it straight out of play for a throw, and England look...
I tell you what, Joe, if Scotland can sense that they can nick a goal here, then England will be in trouble.
England, too, have only suffered two defeats under Serena Wiegmann in this remarkable run that she's had as head coach. Weirs cross for Scotland, headed away by Greenwood. Grimshaw was making a late run, it was just over her head. Scotland still have it deep inside the England half, seeking equaliser. Deflected cross from McLaughlin, behind by Millie Bright on the right foot. It's a Scotland corner in front of the Scotland fans at the Roker end of the stadium. They're 2-1 down, but they're really pushing for an equaliser now.
Yeah, certainly momentum so important in football, and Scotland have got the momentum at the moment, and the players can sense it and know that Caroline Weir's coming out to take this corner, that this is going to be a good ball and be an attack. They have the players to attack it. England just need to be diligent in defence.
Well, two defeats in 9 for England under Serena Wiegmann, having gone 30 games unbeaten at the start of her tenure. Caroline Weir will take the corner. Noise from England supporters, but they have defending to do. Floated up to the edge of the 6-yard box. England clear through Bronze, and then eventually it's James who gets the second touch on the ball to divert it towards the far side. Doherty's going to let it run out of play. Scotland throw midway into England territory, and you heard the belief of the Scotland side before the game kicked off, not just the head coach, but Caroline Weir very vocal about her confidence in Scotland's chances. And Scotland have produced, in many ways, a very good display tonight. Emsley's boot has come off, and she's going to be asked. Is she going to be asked to leave the field here?
No way, surely not. I do think that you're right, Joe. I think that Scotland's game plan has been good. I think that they've split the game into sections. So they knew that the first 15-20 minutes, what they'd have to do, and then can they come out a little bit? Now can they get the attacking players forward? Yes, they did that. Yes, they've conceded goals, but it's all about them developing within this Nations League and trying to get results to the likes of England, where they should really have no chance of beating England. They shouldn't be. They're not in the stratosphere. However, as a team and a collective, they're playing very, very well, and that's what it's all about at international level.
Not lost since February, Scotland. They've got Emsley back on the field. Had to tie laces. England 2, Scotland 1. This is probably, even despite the goal, Scotland certainly their best spell of possession in the game so far, 20 minutes into the second half. And Howard's got it on the halfway line. Howard of Leicester City. Ball down the middle towards Thomas. Thomas has looked good. Formerly of Manchester United, just joined Tottenham. And England have given it away again. Weir down the right-hand side. Left-footed ball infield to find Emsley. Emsley's pass, way too much on it. Weir was never going to get to that. Goal kick to England, but there are some warning signs here for Serena Beegman.
So Scotland's counter-press, so when they lose the ball high up the pitch, they're positioned in such a way that they win it back straight away, and they're so intelligent. Caroline Weir just anticipated a little short pass because they know that England will try and build with short passes, and nearly an opportunity for Scotland. They got themselves right in the penalty area.
Now McLaughlin surging forward down the right-hand side, back infield to Weir, who shoots instinctively. Always wants to go for goal, Caroline Weir. This time England's Georgia Stanway was in the way. And the England supporters creating a light show in the stadium. They've got the torches on their phones and the blinking light everywhere you look, that white light all around the stadium. England 2, Scotland 1. And our producer's a bit bemused by what he's seeing.
So England need to start connecting passes further up the pitch now, and they need to sort of just impose the game back onto Scotland, because Scotland have got a little bit of a hold of it at the moment.
It's a poor pass by James. He's given it straight to Grimshaw of Scotland. Grimshaw immediately with the ball up the right-hand channel, but Greenwood's there to see it back to Earps. Into the final quarter of the game on TalkSport. England 2, Scotland 1. It remains. We'll bring you updates of England's trip to the Netherlands on Tuesday. And there might be some concern in parts for Serena Beegman as she prepares to make her return to her home country and face the side that she used to manage. Foul on Rachel Daly. England free kick midway inside their own half.
Yeah, this has relieved a little bit of pressure. And you see England are not in any sort of hurry whatsoever to take this free kick. They're trying to take the sting out of Scotland. They're building a little bit of a head of steam. They're positioned well. England can't get themselves out. So England need to think now. Can they just turn Scotland around? Can they get the ball in the final third and start to just imprint back on the game? They've just lost a little bit of control now.
England go up the left-hand channel from the free kick. It's cleared away by McLaughlin and out of play for an England throw. This a rivalry with a great history, of course. England and Scotland, the oldest international football rivalry. And a heavyweight contest at Wembley Arena for you tomorrow. The rematch between Zhang and Joyce. And we'll have commentary of that on TalkSport on Sunday. Sam Matterface takes you around the grounds in the Premier League with the Sunday session. England struggling to keep the ball at the moment.
Yeah, this is not a massive rivalry when there's a Mexican wave going round.
That's true.
I think that just tells you the little bit of a difference. It's not quite the rivalry of the men's Scotland and England games.
Maybe it will reach that level someday. I guess a lot of that is about Scotland making sure that they can continue their progress. If they were to get a result tonight, it would be one of Scotland's best results in recent times, that's for sure.
Well, they can certainly sense that they can get an equaliser, but the more that they get forward, then it just may leave spaces. But England just need to concentrate in terms of their ball forward, and defensively, they're just to look a little bit sloppy at times.
Here is Hansen going on the outside of Bronze. Bronze always the favourite there, outmuscles Hansen. She's going to try and get the ball out from inside the penalty area, manages to find Carter. Carter immediately under pressure. England have got to be careful they don't lose the ball here. In the end, Carter's fouled and England win a free kick. And Lucy Bronze was, well, the calm and coolest player in the stadium of light. They're almost too calm and cool for a second.
Yeah, she turned inside towards her own goalkeeper, but Mary Earps had something to say about that. But again, as soon as it's a set piece, it's a free kick, Mary Earps on the edge of the area. She's taking time over it because they know that the second best at the moment, England, so they need to produce a little bit of intensity and get the ball at the other end of the pitch.
Salford 2, Catalan Dragons 8 in the live Super League tonight over on TalkSport 2. Birmingham 0, QPR 0 in the Championship is the latest score. Birmingham need a win to move into the Championship playoff places ahead of the weekend. Your home of EFL, TalkSport 2, has two commentaries for you on Sunday from the Championship, including one here at the Stadium of Light, Sunderland against Cardiff. Kerr has the ball for Scotland, back to Corsi, the captain. Corsi clips the ball upfield, it's spun off the head of Stanway. England look really flat and uninspired at the moment.
These players are tired, by the way, and I know everybody be listening, well, you know, the footballers should be, but they just look leggy to me. They look like there's a lot of minutes in those legs, and they're not quite up to game speed because they've not played in club football. They've not had games yet, and I think that that will take time. But I think because of Scotland being behind in this game, they've just found a little bit more energy.
Caroline Weir looking to wriggle away down the left-hand side, and it's worth remembering as Weir wins a free kick for Scotland in a dangerous position that Scotland's domestic season has been underway for 8 match rounds already so far. So these players are match fit and very much into the rhythm. It's a Scotland throw on that far
side. Yeah, it makes it. I mean, it's some players are playing in the WSL, some players play abroad, but the majority do play in Scotland. It makes a difference because you match fit. You're at the sort of level, and this is a big occasion as well, and that takes quite a lot of energy out of you as players. So hopefully it won't fizzle out this game, but Scotland can certainly see a chance that perhaps that they could push for an equaliser.
It certainly feels like it's fizzling out from an England perspective. England have got 4 or 5 subs warming up on the touchline, a long way down below us. 2-1 they lead Scotland. 03717 22 3344 to speak to the Sports Bar Weekender with Adam Catchell and Carlton Cole once we're done here. Massive array of games in the Premier League tomorrow. Game day live on Talksport from 1 with Adrian Durham. Goals as they go in from the Premier League and EFL. We've got a full check on the classified results after 5 o'clock as well. The only national radio station providing you with a full classified results service. And Burnley against Manchester United is our 8 o'clock commentary tomorrow on Talksport. Talksport 2 will bring you Luton against Wolves. 3 in once we're done here. Faye Carruthers is going to go straight down to Bedfordshire in preparation for coverage of that. A lot of excitement ahead on the weekend. Forward by Stanway up the England right-hand channel. Ella Toon is chasing after that. Juggles the ball over the head of Doherty. Waits for the run of Bronze. Little back heel to find Bronze. Dead ball line. Bronze chips in the cross. Headed away. Drops down towards the edge of the penalty area. Could come here for Daly. Hooks it back in. And then James on the volley over the top.
Yeah, it's better by England. And that was all about Ella Toon's run. She's come on. She hasn't really touched the ball that much. It's been all Scotland the last few minutes. But she made the run. And she was found. It was by Jess Carter. And it just flurry of play. Ball into the box. But England couldn't make the most of it.
18 minutes plus stoppage time to go here. I guess for England, more than anything, they're just about bouncing back after the desperate disappointments in the World Cup final. England so close to winning a first senior World Cup for the men's or women's team since 1966, but beaten by Spain. And so much has happened, of course, since then. Ball is chested down by Thomas for Scotland on the halfway line. Scotland have a player down. It's Hanson, the goal scorer. And the Italian referee has stopped the game. The stoppages haven't helped. And at times in the second half, this is competitive football in the Nations League, but it's had the feel of a friendly in the second half.
Yeah, it's lost a bit of tempo and it's lost a little bit of quality. But it just the fact that that's happened just enables Scotland, if they can just grab the game by the scruff of the neck, to get, because they've got to get back into it. That's how they'll be looking. They don't want to finish bottom of this group. They'll sense a time today where, you know, England look a little bit leggy. Can we get back into it? Can we? And England just need to keep Scotland at arm's length, maybe make changes. I think that there's enough depth on this England bench to make changes and just give some of the girls a rest.
Some of the England subs have been called over to the near side touchline. Scotland with Hanson back on her feet restart the game. Back it goes to goalkeeper Gibson, all in bright yellow, not had a lot to do tonight. Belgium 1, Netherlands 1 elsewhere in the group that contains England and Scotland. England at the Netherlands on Tuesday, and Scotland will host Belgium. The Belgium games, the games that Scotland, I'm sure, will feel they have a chance potentially of winning. Minnie Bright coming across towards the dead ball line and sweeping it clear with her left foot straight out of play. And there's a lethargy, and maybe an understandable lethargy, about England's second half performance, but they do lead 2-1.
Yeah, I do expect Serena Wiegmann to make some, maybe a couple of changes just to add a little bit, but sometimes substitutes don't add that. They sometimes can imbalance. I think Melantoon's not really got herself on the ball, and that's more about the collective of England have not really raised the level in the last sort of 10 or 15 minutes.
Hansen's going up the far side, the Scotland left, quick dynamic feet to get away from Bronson, swinging the cross, Emsley far post, excellent defending from Greenwood to get a vital touch, otherwise Emsley might have been in for the equaliser.
I'll tell you what, the difference between Emsley there and Lauren Hemp in terms of her goal, it's just about attacking it. I think if Emsley had gone for it, she'd have got to the ball first, and it's a terrific ball across the box.
Plenty in the penalty area in the dark blue shirts of Scotland, playing towards the end where the and most of the away supporters seem to have congregated. The Roker end of the stadium. And the reference to the old Roker Park ground. The Stadium of Light is over 25 years old now. Cross to McLaughlin, up comes Mary Earps, flaps that it gets it away only as far as Hansen, a looping effort off the bar! Scotland so close to the equaliser they're so desperate for, and it was Kirsty Hansen who scored at the end of the first half, who so nearly put them level. And here she comes forward again, Jinky away from Bronze, and then she drives the ball miles over the top, the slice with the left foot. The effort a few moments ago was anything but a slice, but it came back off the bar and it's still 2-1 England.
So what's happened is that England have not gone out and engaged Scotland in wide areas. So there have been one or two, probably three good balls into the box that have just left Scotland to attack. And the ball actually came out to Hansen, and she had to be quite inventive. She had to move her feet really quickly. And that nearly looped over Earps, hit the crossbar, and lucky for Hansen.
And Earps was statuesque, nothing that the goalkeeper could do. Scotland on the bounce of play over the course of the 76 minutes that we've had so far, you have to say we'll probably feel that they deserve an equaliser.
I absolutely agree with you, Joe, particularly in the second half. I think that they've grown in confidence. I think they can sense that England are not quite up to speed, and it's just about being ruthless in front of goal. You know, and if it ends like this, they'll probably look back at the penalty incident and think, well, we probably should have got a point anyway.
And no VAR here tonight. Forward by Carter for England. High hanging ball up to the halfway line beneath the very dark skies. We had a lot of rain in the build-up at one stage, but that rain has stopped. Lauren James went up for the header. I think it spun off Doherty last. It did, and it's an England throw midway inside the Scotland half. Yeah. England playing from right to left.
And England are not really in a rush to get themselves up the pitch. They just want to see this game out, and it's a dangerous game to play, but I think they think that they've got enough control over it, or they've got enough players on the pitch to keep Scotland at bay and go with a narrow win.
This one of 450 live games we will bring you this season across the Talksport network. Here come England with Daly, who's peeled out to the left-hand side. Reverse ball looking for the run of Toon on the edge of the penalty area. Sliding in is Howard with a firm and robust challenge to divert the ball up to the halfway line. Less than 13 minutes of normal time to go. Daly, the number nine, marauding forward again into a central position. Had a goal ruled out in the first half. Stanway shoots from a long way out, and that is straight into the gloves of the goalkeeper via a couple of bounces.
Yeah, just lost a little bit of the focal point. Now Daly's moved out left, and James has gone up front with Lauren Hemp.
You hear the noise of many of the 49,000. A sell-out crowd, and England expecting huge crowds at the King Power Stadium for the home game against Belgium in late October that will bring you live on TalkSport, and the Wembley game against the Netherlands as well. England will play Scotland in their final Nations League game in the reverse fixture at Hampden in early December. Thomas dropping deep into our own half for Scotland. Scoops it to the halfway line, but Greenwood's there with a neat cushion touch to find Rachel Daly. And now Zelem, a calm presence on the ball in the centre circle. Zelem, who helped Manchester United finish second last season and reach an FA Cup final. Ball up the middle is a poor one, straight to the Scotland goalkeeper. Zelem's pass for Bronze's goal in the first half was a thing of beauty, and Daly's cross for Hemp's flying header likewise. And clearly the highlight for England has been, I think, the craft involved in the two goals that they scored.
Absolutely, top-class goals, both of England's goals. And I think that you look at them now trying to see out the game, and Scotland have just got to make it about the last 10 minutes or so, make it about a 10-minute game and see whether they can just take a few more risks to get that equaliser.
It is that time of the year where you feel like everything's happening in the sporting world. The return of the Ryder Cup next weekend, Talksport Breakfast, Alan Brazil and Ali McCoist, live from Rome on Thursday and Friday morning from 6 a.m. So much excitement, no doubt, and tales of the journey that Alan and Ali will have in Rome over the weekend. Plenty to come and lots to look forward to tomorrow as well. Burnley against Manchester United, followed by Fight Night Live from Wembley Arena. And Scotland have possession with Thomas, a heavy touch midway inside the England half. She's shrugged aside by Millie Bright, Leah Williamson, Beth Mead and Fran Kirby still unavailable for England. And back it goes to Earps. Earps out to the right and Bronze. And backwards again to the England goalkeeper. Pace of the game has really dropped for England in the second half. The first half felt very competitive and very exciting indeed. But the second half, you can see the fatigue is coming into play. These England players need some rest. And of course, they're not going to get much of it because the start of the WSL season is just around the corner.
Yeah, I think it's odd timing. I understand it's because of the World Cup. If the World Cup had been a little bit earlier, perhaps this international break makes some sense because the domestic leagues would have started. But it has an effect on players, and I think we visibly can see that, particularly with England. I think Scotland have got the bit between the teeth that they think that they can get. They've got something to aim for, that equaliser. And I think England look like they just want to see the game out.
Well, they've got less than 9 minutes plus stoppage time to do so here, England. Here is Howard for Scotland. Number five, corner of the penalty area. A lot of England fans are heading for the exits early here. Empty red seats are starting to appear. I feel like they've seen enough, some of the England fans. Important for England, though, to bounce back with a win. If they can hold on here, and that'll be a step at least. It won't take away the memory of the World Cup final, of course, entirely, but it's at least a step towards doing so.
Yeah, you're just going to keep moving forward. It was disappointing. It was small margins, but England need to keep going. You know, there's Euros to come, the Olympics to come, obviously, as GB they want to qualify for, but the Euros is really, really important, and that's the next step. Can they win the Euros? And you just got to keep looking forward as a player.
649 days till the start of Euro 2025. A couple of changes for Scotland. Martha Thomas, who's had an excellent game, is leaving the field, just hasn't managed to convert what she's had into goals. And Thomas is replaced by Amy Gallagher for a Scotland debut. The Celtic player who's had a blistering start to the league season. And the other change sees Claire Emsley go off. And Lisa Evans, who we know well in England in the WSL, the West Ham player, formerly of Arsenal, converted that loan to a permanent deal, is onto the field herself for her 98th Scotland cap tonight.
Yeah, Lisa Evans, she probably considered herself unlucky not to start this game. Wily character, can play a number of positions in wide areas, defensive or forward player.
Former title winner in the WSL with her old club Arsenal, Lisa Evans. We're in the 83rd minute, England 2, Scotland 1 on Talk Sports. Stanway back to Zellum, and Zellum to the feet of Millie Bright. We'll have to spin and turn away from the onrushing Gallagher, who's straight into the action, putting the pressure on Mary Earps. She comes from a footballing family, Amy Gallagher. Her dad, her great-granddad Patsy, was a Celtic legend of the past. And Amy Gallagher making her Scotland debut tonight against England. A memorable moment for her.
Brilliant. And for the family, I'm sure, that they're all here watching. And it's been good for Scotland, I think. I think they'll gain a lot of confidence. I think that they've just had lacking in luck and a little bit of quality in front of goal. We keep talking about that penalty that wasn't given. I think they'll be pleased with what they've done, but can they just go that extra step and get themselves an equaliser?
Save for Mary Earps in the first half as well to deny Caroline Weir. And Scotland have been impressive, but it's England who overwhelmingly know how to win under Serena Wiegmann, heading for a 32nd victory in 40 matches under their head coach. And England win a free kick, fouled by McLaughlin on Daly on the halfway. And good refereeing by the referee Maria Solly Caputi, because some referees might have given a yellow card for that, but she rather sensibly says, look, talking to is all you need in that situation.
Yeah, and it helps England as well. When you foul England like that, they take time over the free kick and they just winding the clock down, using the set piece, getting the ball in certain areas and just seeing if they can get that third goal that completely kill the game off.
The ball is with Stanway on the halfway line. Outside of the two goals, England haven't really tested the Scotland goalkeeper. They've given it away now to Weir. Weir driving forward through the midfield up to the edge of the penalty area. Wide to the near side, the Scotland right. Opportunity for the substitute to lay it square to Grimshaw. And it's straight at the goalkeeper. It was Lisa Evans with the pullback. Grimshaw running onto it, straight down the throat of Earps. And she should have done better.
Yeah, she's just making sure at the edge of the area. Grimshaw, and again that's Caroline Weir. She has been absolutely outstanding. She's just elite in terms of the way that she wins the ball, the way that she passes forward, a vision. And she's all about how Scotland get themselves forward.
Chanting around the ground is for Mary Earps, the England goalkeeper. Very much England's number one, absolutely untouchable really. There aren't many who would get on the team sheet before Mary Earps for any England game. She is the lioness of the year. Rachel Daly retreating back towards her own goal, back past two Earps. Earps faced it safety first with a clearance. The referee has spotted something here. She stopped the game. She's looking towards Lauren James, who's out on her own inside the Scotland half. What's the referee done here?
No, that's something to do with a foul. Well, I don't know whether there was a coming together. Lauren James further up the pitch, but the referee stopped it. He was a substitute as well.
And the ball's in the hands of Earps, and Scotland are going to make a change, and it's McLaughlin who is coming off, Rachel McLaughlin of Rangers. And the Scotland change sees Fiona Brown, who plays her football for Rosengard, come onto the field, a very experienced Scotland international. She's enjoyed over 50 caps in a Scotland shirt, and the referee's just explaining the situation here to Weir and Earps, and in the end the ball is dropped to the feet of the England goalkeeper. Not entirely sure what's gone on there. England 2, Scotland 1. 4 minutes to go on TalkSport. Saturday afternoon's return with Adrian Durham. Game day live from 1 o'clock tomorrow. 3 o'clock on TalkSport 2. Commentary of Luton against Wolves. Burnley against Manchester United at 8. That's followed by Fight Night Live from Wembley Arena. Zhang up against Joyce. Sunday, Sam Matterface with the Sunday session. We've got goals as they go in from the Premier League. We've got two commentaries from the Championship on TalkSport 2. Three NFL commentaries into the evening on TalkSport 2 as well. Updates from the Rugby World Cup, the Solheim Cup, the F1, and the second ODI between England and Ireland. And then from TalkSport Breakfast, Monday morning from 6, the build-up starts to the Ryder Cup. Alan Brazil and Annie McCoys will be live in Rome on Thursday and Friday. Lots to look forward to. Throw to England, deep inside the Scotland half. England playing with the sort of look of a team who actually just want this game to be over.
Yeah, that's exactly what they look like, Joe. They look like they just want the time to go down. Do you know what? Lucy Bronze has just thrown it at Lauren James's back to get on the ball.
And it's pulled back into the penalty area for Hemp. Hemp onto that favoured left foot. Blocked off at the last by Howard, who was caught by Hemp on the follow through. The referee eventually gives Scotland the free kick, and rightly so. Hemp just opened up for her for a second, but she was surrounded by Scotland shirts.
You don't see that often, actually. We used to do it all the time. When you throw the ball against the back of one of your teammates and then receive it back from a throw-in, and the other team just don't know what's going on. And it actually got England in front of goal, but the referee's just pulled it up for a foul. A couple of Scottish players on the floor. They've certainly given a lot in this game.
Hansen's gone down. And you are absolutely right, Lucy, with what you said earlier. A lot of these Scotland players nowadays play their football outside of Scotland. Well over 40,000 here tonight at the Stadium of Light. 41,000 plus, which is a great crowd. And Belgium lead the Netherlands by 2-1. Elsewhere in England's Nations League group, so a late winner for Belgium, it looks like. And indeed, is that full time in that game? It is. That's a win for Belgium.
Big win for Belgium, because Netherlands were very, very impressive at times during the World Cup.
Yeah, surprising victory. Belgium, who England will face at home on the 27th of October, live on the TalkSport network. The game has been stopped, and lots more England fans now. They're trickling out of the stadium in their hundreds. And Scotland's Hansen still receiving some treatment. Millie Bryant speaking to Serena Peake. Are you surprised that
seen more changes, Lucy, as this half's gone on.
Well, all I'm thinking, Joe, is that she's got a team in mind for tonight. She's got a team in mind for the Netherlands away, and she probably doesn't want to venture away from any substitutions that she was probably going to make in terms of this game, and feels that the players that started it and the ones that have come on can cope with what happens and the load that they're going to have. And I will suspect there'll be a few changes for Tuesday night.
We'll keep you updated with that game on Talk Sport. England's trip to the Netherlands, where Serena Wiegmann really made her name on the international stage, a winner at Euro 2017 and a runner-up in the 2019 World Cup against the USA. Now then, Hansen's gone off for Scotland here. She's been forced to leave the field due to injury. And Lauren Davidson of Glasgow City, who are the dominant force in Scotland domestically in their top flight, is going to come on. A lot of encouragement for Scotland about this performance. Just three added minutes at the end of the game. England 2, Scotland 1. Can the Scots force an equaliser? They don't really look like doing so at the moment, but you never know. There might still be time. Now an England player has gone down on halfway. That's Hemp, who's gone to ground. And Lauren Hemp looks like she's probably scored the winner ultimately tonight.
Yeah, it was a terrific goal. You know, both her goal and Lucy Bronze's goal were the highest order. Those two bits of quality may have won England the game.
Here is Daly on the halfway line. Infield to Zellum. Back to Greenwood now. Greenwood to Toon. Toon dispossessed. Scotland looking fresher, and certainly in their final third with the changes that they've made. Howard has the ball, the defender clips it long over the halfway line. England 2, Scotland 1. We are just under a minute through of three added. 03717 223344 for the sports bar weekender to come. Looking back on this evening, looking ahead to all of the weekend's football and more as well with Adam Cattrall and Carton Cole once we're done here. And the ball is on the halfway line with Brown for Scotland. She's given it away. Hemp has chipped it up the middle. Lauren James could be in. James is racing clear. Angle tight, she shoots. Saved by the goalkeeper. But James is there to head the rebound in. But the flag is up again on the far side of the field. England are going to be denied. And it's a reprieve for Scotland. The boo's in the stadium.
Just
James,
miles
as she was put through, was offside.
Absolutely miles offside. In fact, she was that far offside, the assistant referee, she didn't even wait until she got onto the ball. She just put a flag up, and I think that's the right decision.
Good spot, Lucy Ward, from a long way away where the assistant is on the far side. So it's still 2-1 to England. Scotland a minute to go of stoppage time. They've got a free kick just shy of halfway. They might as well send everybody forward.
I think this is it, because it started to drift away, hasn't it, the last sort of five or so minutes for Scotland. I think there's been that many stoppages, stop start, substitutions, that little bit of momentum that they built has just disappeared.
Goalkeeper Gibson's got this free kick on halfway. 40 seconds to go, surely the last chance. Gibson pumps it long. Howard is up there to flick it on. Could fall for Davidson at the far post, but Lucy Bronze is there to regain possession for England. Great flick by Howard, and with heart in hearts in mouth there.
Because that's what you saw, when you get a ball into the box from as far away as that, it's all about getting the first contact. Scotland did that, and then it causes problems, but Lucy Bronze's pace just cleared up for England.
20 seconds to go. Gallagher's got it on for Scotland, midway inside the England half. Plays it towards the left-hand side. Cross whipped in towards Brown at the far post, heads it down. Marriott will pounce on it, and that should probably be that. All eyes on the referee. England leads Scotland 2-1, and the game is over. And England have started their inaugural Nations League campaign with a win. And 33 days on from that agonising World Cup final defeat, there is some redemption for Serena Wiegmann's Lionesses. All about moving on, all about moving forward tonight. Familiar faces, but it does feel somewhat like the start of a new era for the Lionesses. And in this great fixture with so much history, they've edged out the old enemy in the northeast tonight to begin their League A campaign with 3 points. Lucy Bronze and Lauren Hemp with flying headers late in the first half. Kirsty Hansen pulled one back for Scotland just before the break. It was a brave and impressive Scotland display, but they couldn't force an equaliser late on. And to cheers of 41,000 here at the Stadium of Light, it's England, yet again it's England, who get the victory. 32 wins out of 40 under Serena Wiegmann. They have beaten Scotland tonight by 2-1.
Thank you very much, Joe Shannon. Joe's heading down to the tunnel to speak to Serena Wiegmann and some of the players. And we'll be bringing you all that post-match reaction here across the TalkSport network. Lucy Ward, I feel as if I kind of say this on a regular basis at the moment about this England side. They did it, but it wasn't pretty.
Yeah, it doesn't always have to be pretty. I think you've got to take into account a lot of factors and quite a lot of the timing of this game, that, you know, how much it means to Scotland, you know, how much it means to both teams. And the fact that Scotland have got a manager now that they're developing with, that they've got players that they feel confident that they can set out a game plan and see out the game plan. And it was hard work, really hard work at times for England. I think they just had enough, they just did enough, and just doing enough to get through things, games like this, is enough. That's fine. But from a Scotland point of view, very, very positive for them.
Positive, but they'll be so disappointed, won't they? Because they actually, not just taken a point away, they could have had all three.
They absolutely could. And I think that when the dust settles tomorrow and leading into the next game for Scotland, I think they'll think that positive. But now they'll be gutted. They'll be gutted that they thought, we just had a chance, we played in a certain way, we could have had a penalty, we should have been a little bit more clinical, make the most of the big moments. They didn't quite manage to do that, but they did enough that it just means that the players and the squad look at the manager and each other and think, actually, we've got something going here. And I think that that's what positivity will come out of Scotland's performance.
Yeah, they're just going over to applaud their fans over on the far right-hand side behind the goal where they were shooting towards in the second half. A pocket of Scotland fans with their flags over in the corner. The England team, as we always see at the end of a match since Serena Wiegmann has taken charge, a big huddle going on. A conversation about how that match was. They got the 3 points. It's a big start and a good start in this Nations League campaign ahead of an away fixture against Serena Wiegmann's former side, the Netherlands, on Tuesday night, which I'll bring you reports from Utrecht during around the grounds, where we've got loads of Carabao Cup action coming with Adrian Durham all across next week. So much live football for you. In fact, there's live football going on right now in the EFL Championship. Abigail Davis is watching Birmingham City against Queen's Park Rangers.
Yeah, 9 minutes remain.